What's up, guys? Welcome back to the video. I hope you like the intro that me and my brother did, which I'll give him a little bit of credit. Hey. That's my brother. So today we're actually going to be reviewing my car. This is my 2020 Corolla hatchback that I got in June because I flipped my Kia, as you guys know. I'm going to be going over all the specs in a voiceover and just giving you my overall thought of the 2020 hatchback, if it's worth the buy or if it's better to lay. So that said, let's hop into the video. So, one of the main things that I like about this car is the fucking interactive 8-inch touchscreen display. I have music up on it right now, but you can do Google Maps, call people, send text, the whole nine yards, and it works with Android Auto and Apple CarPlay. Also, if you couldn't tell, the seats are a lot more comfortable than my Kia. They're more of a sporty look. Handling-wise, on the road, shocks are a little bit better. They're more responsive. They sit a little bit lower to the ground. And the manual sports mode is pretty awesome. So this is the sports button that I'm going to be hitting here in a second once I get around these bends. And I'll show you what the response time is like with and without. So this is without right now. And there's also an eco option that I personally turned off because I want more power than saving gas, stupidly. But there's always that option of saving gas and whatnot with the eco, essentially. So, we'll give you the cinematic view of my hometown. You want to shoot out the window there, good Mike?
The camera like cracking a little.
It was like, oh shit.
Come on, you stupid camera. Okay, we got that.
I'm going to hit the sports button that we showed before. It's in sport. It's in manual. I got paddle shifts, so I'm going to be paddle shifting. As you can tell, the manual intelligence manual transmission is very responsive. It's a lot better in the Kia, or a lot better in the Corolla than it was in the Kia. I had that one in the Kia too. It was a different model and obviously older brand, so it wasn't as advanced technology wise. This one, as soon as I hit the button, transmission responds. Doing about 50 and 60 now in fifth gear. So you can use sports mode and automatic. I just like to use it in sports mode, and the combination of paddle shifts, just because it gives me that feel that I'm in control of the speed and stuff. And you can shift when you want. When you're in automatic, the transmission control module already has preset RPM settings to where it's supposed to shift, so you don't get the max RPM usage per gear unless you're in manual mode, because you're obviously in control of that. Aside from that, like I said, I like the way it handles. Its response time is great. All the technology features are pretty up to date for a standard Toyota.
Features.
Yeah, features.
You said features.
Same thing, you dork. What my co-pilot said. The main reason that sold me on this car was the look. It's a more sporty look compared to the regular Corolla sedan and the interactive touchscreen display, which I didn't have before in the 2015 Kia Forte. So, I guess the last thing to really do is give you a sound test. I'm probably going to get a copyright, but they can go suck my dick.
Says she tired of money, need a big boy. Pull up 20-inch blades like I'm Lil Troy. Now it's everybody flocking, need a decoy. Shorty mixing up the vodka with the liquor. G-Wagon, 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 G-Wagon. All the housewives pulling up. I got a lot of toys.
So, yeah, that was Post Malone. Don't own the song at all. She's using it as a demonstration. But yeah, so that's the bass that the music has. It's without subs. The Kia had a sub in it. I have it out in my garage right now. I'm not sure if I'm going to be even thinking about putting one in this car because of how small and compact it is. even though it is possible, I'm not saying it's not possible, it's just I like the having trunk room, and if I added the 12 sub that I have, it would eat up most of the trunk room, and I wouldn't have anywhere to put my tools for work. So, that said, guys, I'll probably go back to the voiceover or something. So, that is my overall thoughts of this car is it's worth the money. It's a Toyota, so you know it's going to last a lot longer compared to a Chevy or Ford, in my personal opinion. The things that you run into issues at with a Chevy, just for an example, for a Cruze, you will have a leak every way, shape, and form. I'm not lying to you. I work at a Chevy dealership. They're garbage. Never buy a Cruze. This is just my personal opinion. Malibus are pretty decent. Impalas are pretty decent. Their Silverados are also pretty decent if you're going to go for a truck. Their Silverado is basically a Tacoma for the Toyota, essentially. And they have bigger Silverados, I believe. And then you also have in Toyota, Tundra.
Tacoma?
Yeah, Tacoma, and then you have the Tundras, which is the bigger trucks. But yeah, personally, the reason I went with a Corolla, even though I work at a Chevy dealership, was reliability. Even though I'm paying $27,000 for this car, it will last me way, way long after I pay it off. So that's, you gotta look into the future. So, okay, let's say you get a Chevy's life normally would be 100,000 miles or something like that, which is a lot for a car, but when you look at the Toyota line, you're looking at cars that have 200,000 miles, 300,000 miles. So essentially, they're built, I don't want to say better, but I guess in a way better. And they're more, I personally believe, reliable. This is just stuff that I've seen in my shop that just like are mind blowing. It's like we had Equinox with 3,000 miles on it, and they already need new tires. Like, that's insane. Then you look at the Cruzes, like how I said, they leak from every orifice on their body, and it's just like, okay, you have a car that has 5,000 miles on it, and you have a tranny coolant leak. Sorry, but you have to replace it, or you're just gonna have more leaking issues, you know. And a lot of times, don't get me wrong, it's covered under warranty, so it's not a big deal. But there's times where, you know, okay, you just replace the transmission coolant lines. Now the old oil lines, coolant lines are leaking, and I don't have the warranty coverage anymore or anything like that. And I'll have, like, list part displays for you to just show you. Just, like, some parts are just, like, expensive, and then the labor on top of that is insane. I'm through a tunnel, by the way. So that's probably why it's super fucking dark.
Well, half your face was lit up a little.
Okay, so that works. But, yeah, man, I mean, don't get me wrong, Chevy, I'm not trying to knock Chevy or Ford off, you know. I loved my Cavalier, that was my first car, but the reason, like how I said, I would recommend this car to anyone of my friends. I tell my friends all the time never to buy a Cruze because you'll just have issues with them. That's just me. That's just personally me. I'm not trying to knock Chevy or anything like that off or say they're the worst car brand. They're not. But yeah, guys, let me know your thoughts down in the comments. I'll have specs of the engine and torque and stuff showed either on screen through the B-roll footage or down in the description for you guys. And I hope this video helps for anyone in the car market right now. I got this, like I said, last month, and I've had yet to have a complaint about it, other than it needs some bigger cup holders, because some Gatorade, it doesn't want to fit.
Oh my god, that...
It's like Tyrone, it's trying to enter the butthole.
That's going to get demonetized. YouTube.
Whoops. Alright guys, hope you liked the video. I'll see you guys next week, and yeah, stay classy. We'll be right back.